You guys voted, so Morocco. Today, the flag of Morocco looks like this. A plain red field with the state ensign in the center, a green five-pointed star. But this flag only started being used in 1915. So what does it mean? And how has Morocco's flag evolved until becoming this particular flag? The history of Morocco dates back a long time, as does everywhere else's, if you want to look at it that way. In classical to late antiquity, the land we now call Morocco was ruled by various peoples, one after another and sometimes at the same time. The Phoenicians, the Carthaginians, the Romans, and also by some Berber kingdoms. Each of these peoples had their own symbols and sometimes even standards. The Phoenicians had their alphabet, Carthage is said to have had a military standard of a half-crescent moon, plus the symbol of the goddess Tanit, which they used, their moon goddess, and the symbol was similar to those we see in antiquity Egypt. Here are a few earrings from that time, shaped like that. The Romans used the symbols and standards we all know, and even some Berber kingdoms had specific ways of representing themselves, even if through direct representations of themselves, like the back of this Roman coin, where the Mauritanian king Bocchus I is depicted. But none of these were Morocco itself, and despite being part of the territory's history, they aren't as much part of the nation's history as the cases we'll see next. After these early antiquity peoples came the Muslim conquest of North Africa. The conquest of the Maghreb region was a part of a century of rapid Muslim conquests into the Byzantine-controlled territories of North Africa. The conquest of Maghreb commenced in 647 and concluded in 709, with the Byzantine Roman Empire losing its last remaining strongholds in the region. And so, a period of Moroccan history called Early Islamic began, lasting from the 8th to the 10th century AD. During these times, the territory of Morocco was ruled by a few different dynasties and through various forms. Let's take a look at those. First was the Umayyad Caliphate. This was in the year 661. The Umayyads didn't have a flag, at least not one I could find, but there are some symbols we can see, like this coin from around 675, where on the left, we see a profile image of what I imagine was a ruler surrounded by what seemed to be crescent moons and stars. On the right, these are also present, plus what is described as a winged creature right on a fire altar with ribbons and attendants. I have no idea what it is or what it means. There were a bunch of other kingdoms and dynasties in the region and surrounding areas, like the Emirate of Nekord or the Barguata Confederacy, but those don't really matter for this video, because this isn't an in-depth look at the history of Morocco, it's about the history and meaning of its flag, and these aren't important because they did not have a registered flag. The first flag that we are able to identify in Moroccan history is the flag of the Idrisid dynasty, named after the founder of the dynasty, Idris I. They ruled from 788 to 974 and are considered to be the founders of the first Moroccan state. Their flag was very simple, a plain white one, and this was in use from 780 to 974, along the lines of the time which they ruled the country. During this period, Moroccans only carried white silk banners during battles and wars. And this was the first Moroccan flag, a plain white banner. In 1040, the ruling dynasty were now the Almoravids, and they kept the Idrisid white banner, however they added some texts to it, in black. Presumably the name of the dynasty, however, some people state that the text on the flags varied, and was usually a selection of Quranic inscriptions, so I'm guessing quotes from the Islamic holy book. According to the same source, Almoravids gave one banner to every unit of 100 soldiers, and the leaders always carried the same text on their banner. Throughout the following centuries, the region of Morocco came under the control of a few other dynasties and a few other types of kingdoms/regimes. In 1121, the Almohad Caliphate was created and this flag was put into use. A red field with a black and white checkered pattern square in the center of 8x8, although sometimes this is depicted as 4x4. This was the first time that the red color was used in the flag of Morocco, and it seems to be the origin point for the color. However, the checkered pattern in black and white also brings us to other colors, white and black. And some people say these three colors represented three of Morocco's dynasties. Red might refer to the Fatimids, white to the Umayyads, and black to the Abbasids. But then the regime changed again in 1244, and the Marinid Sultanate became the controller of Morocco. Their flag was still red, but with a golden frame and an emblem, also in gold, in the center, which replaced the symbol of the previous dynasty, which the Marinid had overthrown. They look like two squares, with one of them being at an angle. Apparently, they are interlaced in a way that they form a star. This might be the origin point for today's green star on the Moroccan flag, although we also saw those earlier examples of symbols that contain the traditional crescent, moon, and star. So maybe it was a continuous form of representation since back then. In this picture depicting historical flags of that time, we see the red and gold one, but also the same pattern in different colors, sometimes with additional symbols like the star and crescent moon, plus these circles which I couldn't really identify. Another dynasty existed after this, the Waracid in 1472, but I couldn't find any different flag for them, and after them came the Saadi dynasty, which recovered the Marinid Sultanate's flag, but also the first Idrizid white banner, and apparently they used both of them at the same time. And then, finally, came the current Alawid dynasty, which implemented their own flag in the year of 1665, a plain red field. A few hundred years later, in 1912, Morocco began a period of being somewhat of a French protectorate, also being under heavy Spanish influence, considering the Spanish still controlled a portion of their territory. And at this time, in 1912, the green five-pointed star was added to the flag. Interestingly, the Spanish protectorate in Morocco flew a similar flag, also red with a green canton and the same star emblem, although smaller inside the canton and in white, while the French protectorate flag was simply the national one with a French flag on the top left. The five points of the star are said to stand for love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice. While Morocco was under French and Spanish control, the red flag with the seal in the center remained in use, but only in land. And at sea, its use was prohibited. When independence was restored in 1956, it once again became the national flag in all aspects. While the red background on the Moroccan flag is said to represent hardiness, bravery, strength, and valor, and the green represents joy, love, wisdom, peace, and hope. It also represents the color of Islam, with some people stating that it's also related to the seal of Solomon. The five branches could also represent the five pillars of Islam. They also have two Varian flags, which I had no idea about. One places a golden crown with a star on top of it on the top left corner, and this is the civil ensign, while the naval ensign, another variant, takes that same crown but places it in all four corners. The royal ensign is equal to the state flag, but with a green star being bordered by gold. Throughout history, there were also some other flags being flown on Moroccan territory. For instance, from 1921 to 26, a few people in North Morocco revolted against both the Spanish and the Sultan, attempting to create an independent republic of Rif, whose flag was similar to Morocco's, red with a wide-angled square and a green crescent and star. Another example is the flag of Tangier. To solve a disagreement among France, Spain, and Britain over its control, Tangier was made a neutral, demilitarized zone in 1924 until 1956. This flag was also red with the Moroccan state emblem on the right and what I assume is the local coat of arms on the left. There was also this flag, red with white triangles as a border and a pair of scissors represented. This kept showing up in a lot of sources that I checked for this video, but never identifying what it represented. But some last until today. The flags of the two autonomous Spanish cities in North Africa, previous colonial possessions of the Spanish and the Portuguese, connected to Morocco, which remain under Spanish rule today. The flag of Melilla is blue with the local coat of arms in the center, while the flag of Ceuta is an odd case. It is located in Morocco, belongs to Spain, but flies a flag with the Portuguese coat of arms and, coincidentally, the background pattern of the Portuguese capital city of Lisbon. This is because Ceuta was previously Portuguese. The Spanish took it at a time of royal union between the two kingdoms, and then, when the Portuguese got their independence back, the Spanish kept Ceuta, but also decided to keep the local flag. As for the coat of arms of Morocco, the coat of arms of Morocco was adopted on August of 1957, and it features a gold-bordered red shield with a rising sun, Atlas Mountains, and a green five-pointed star. There is a lion at either side of the shield and a crown on top, plus a banner stating, "If you glorify God, he will glorify you," in Arabic. The royal standard is a depiction of the coat of arms upon a dark green field, different from the royal flag which we just saw earlier. So that is a brief overlook at the history and meaning of the Moroccan flag, how the region first started representing itself, the various banners it used throughout its various regimes, rulers, and dynasties, sometimes even with foreign occupators or specific cases, evolving with each color and symbol, having its origin at some point along the way before reaching today's version, the flag of Morocco that we all know. Thanks so much for watching. As always, leave a comment with any mistakes you might have noticed or missing information that I didn't find. Subscribe if you want to catch future videos, and I will see you next time for more general knowledge.